They started the race, big one happened, lightning strike, rain, and I was looking at the radar, and it was just coming straight to the track. It was coming straight to the track.
It always does.
I told my dad, I said, dude, I said, this is about to be at least 2 hours rain, and it's going to take a 2 hours drive track. I said, we had rain jackets. We were already prepared and stuff. And I said, well, 2020 prepared us. And I was like, dude, let's just huck it to the truck. I was like, I'd rather sit in the truck and take a nap and sit here in the bleachers, bored as shit.
Right.
And he was like, yeah, you think it's going to rain that long? I said, dude, no, like, this thing's probably about to get rained out. Right. We walked back to the truck, but we were soaking wet. And then we chilled in the truck, and it was probably like 4 o'clock when we got to the truck. We're chilling. I'm listening to MRN. I'm checking stuff, and it looks like more rain's coming. And it's literally like, I think they're going to call it. And it's like, I don't think NASCAR's going to call it. I think Fox is going to call it. And that's the thing. We waited around. It was 7:30, 8 o'clock, where they said, we think we can go racing by 9. And they said that. So I was like, oh, it hasn't rained in like 30 minutes. Like, and I was looking, and it looked like the rain was breaking up. They were like, hey, drivers to your cars at 8:45. I was like, it was like 8. I was like, dad, we need to get our shoes on. Right. Like, let's go. So we went back to track. And funny story short, you know, I don't really care. I was like, dad, it rained. I was like, probably half these people went home. Like, we saw a bunch of traffic leaving and stuff. Right. I was like,
of course.
I was like, let's go sneak in some good seats. Like, let's go up in the towers and get in the tri-oval. And dad was like, yeah, let's do it. And we did that last year on the Monday rain out too. And we sat like right on the start finish line. It's pretty cool. But so we went up in the towers and we're like, dude, look, it's wide open. It's already wide open because of COVID. It's pretty cool. But we were like sitting there, la di da di da. And drivers are coming to their cars. And this dude came up, this dude and like his grandma or mom or something. He came up and he approached me and my dad all wrong. Like, I'm pretty chill, totally relaxed person. I don't get in people's faces about nothing. I'm fucking chill. And this dude comes up in the row in front of us. Me and my dad are sitting there just kind of waiting. They're cranking the engines. And this dude's like, hey, man, I don't know who y'all are, but y'all, these ain't y'all's seats. And I'm like, ah, shit, this is this guy's seat. Like, we need to move. Like, we're busted. And so me and my dad are like, hey, man, no worries. Blah, blah, blah. Like, we're going to get up for you. And he said, no. He said, you need to get the fuck out of here. And that's what the guy said. Dude. And I was like, I looked at him sideways. Like, dude, like, chill the fuck out. This dude was like 50. And like, there's one thing, like, look, I don't have a leg to stand on. I think I'm in his seat. And I was like, but you don't talk to people like that.
No.
And my dad was like, hey, man, take it easy. And my dad's almost 60. He wasn't fighting nobody or nothing. But I was kind of, it was one of those things where after it happened, I got more mad about it.
Right. Of course. And you're like, I wish I was cooler.
Yeah. And I was like, hey, man, it's all good, dude. And he was like, no, y'all need to get the fuck out of here. And he was like, y'all don't even belong in this section. And I was like, you just think you're so fucking cool, don't you? I don't know why I said that. Me and my dad just walked down the row and sat on some other seats. And, like, guy didn't say nothing. But then we saw a family come and sit down in the front rows. And the guy we weren't even in his seats. We were in the row behind him. Like, he was sitting in the row in front of us. He didn't want us to sit next or near him because it was 6 feet. He didn't want us to sit near him. So he told us to get up. And like, we weren't even in seats. And I was like, dude, I was seeing that. I got so mad. I was like, dude, I ought to go over there and push that guy over there.
That's so weird. I never have bad experiences at NASCAR.
No, that's one thing.
That's so like, weird. That never
that
happens. Usually,
usually
people walk up and they like hand you a beer. They're like, hey, man, what's up? Like, NASCAR is so chill.
The Daytona 500 kind of gets a different crowd than a lot of other races.
Oh, that makes sense.
We'll go down that road. But if it was me, I would have been like, hey, man, y'all are kind of in our seats. And I'd expect them to move and be like, no worries, like, whatever. This guy was, like, pissed.
Yeah, we weren't even like, seats. I'd be like, hey, guys, you know, this is my seats right here. Y'all mind just, like, moving back a couple rows or,
yeah,
like, over
no,
a little
he,
bit? Not
he
a big
went
deal.
And got a ticket lady and told on everybody. There was other people that were sitting in seats that weren't supposed to. This ticket lady came up and was like, hey, let me see your tickets. Let me see your tickets. And, like, me and my dad were, like, sweat rolling down her forehead, like, oh, shit, he went told. And I was like, if she comes over here, I ain't saying shit. I was like, if she's asking me to see her tickets, I'm going to tell her no.
and it sucks because you try to reason with the ticket people, but they don't care.
Yeah.
Because I've been in that situation,
like,
where you're like, nobody's around. Can we just be chill?
I was like, she's just doing her job. But
tickets, please.
Me and my dad just ignored her and watched the race. And she walked past us, asked people, what do these people ask people, and didn't ask us shit. And we were like, okay.
Dude, I have so many situations like that at NASCAR races that I've done that exact same thing. But the opposite has happened.
This guy was just being an asshole. I have friends who are like, hey, where are you sitting? And literally, usually if you go to races, you're trying to get friends to go, or you got a group of people, and it's harder to do it. The more people you have, the harder to do it. But it's one little good thing that's been about COVID is a social distance seating. is if it's just me and a buddy, or I take my wife to a lot of races. Like if my buddy's like, hey, I can't go to that one, I was like, we're going. And I'll take my girl to races and stuff. And I feel like it's just two of us, I'll be like, we're going to go sit where we want to sit. And it's kind of like you just walk it like you talk it. If you walk in and act like those are your seats and that's where you're going to sit, if no one comes and is like, hey, that's my seat, then you're golden. I've the last eight races I've been to, I've never even gone to my seat. I've just been like, you know what? I think I want to sit today. I think I'm going to sit out of turn four. And I'll just go over there and be like, hey, there's an empty row. And I'll just go sit in an empty row. And 95% of the time, no one says shit.